In Midland and Odessa, a state of disaster has been declared. There are still no confirmed cases of COVID-19 in either city. The declaration is just a precaution to gain federal and state funding. Big 2's Felice Romero is digging deeper into this state of emergency to find out what this could mean moving forward. Felice.
Eddie, both cities have banned gatherings with more than 50 people. And if need be, they can start enforcing things like a curfew or fine people who don't follow this rule. But there are some exceptions, and both city leaders want to make sure everyone understands what this declaration means.
And at this time, we felt that it was the best time to go ahead and declare an emergency.
First and foremost, we're opening up these declarations so as two cities, we can gain access to state and federal funds, and anything the state and federal government offers to us, we need to have these declarations in place.
After much discussion, both the mayor of Odessa and Midland have come together to declare a state of emergency, stating that, quote, a person who participates in, arranges, or encourages a gathering in violation of this declaration is guilty of a crime punishable as a Class C misdemeanor or a fine not to exceed $500.
Exceptions to that, and some of those things are like malls or places of worship or grocery stores, and you may ask, why are there so many exceptions? Well, a lot of it has to do with movement of people rather than just tight groups gathering.
Other places not included in this rule are government offices, licensed daycare facilities, office spaces, hotels, stores, weddings, and funerals.
We want to make sure that it's easy for our communities to understand the needs and, most importantly, the precautions we all need to take.
The worst thing you can do is hurry out to Walmart or Sam's or HEB or your favorite grocery store and think that we've entered another stretch of danger and emergency.
Both mayors can suspend any provision or prohibit any order in this document at any time.
This is a very fluid situation. Things are changing daily.
The declaration will take effect immediately. City officials will reevaluate each declaration each 7 days and reassess if it needs to continue. Reporting live in studio, Felice Romero, Big 2 News.